Hello and welcome to NewsClick. US Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has just completed a visit to India. And some may wonder what has actually been achieved since she's spent about 5 days, but just a few hours in discussions with the top leadership in India. To discuss her visit, we have with us John Cherian. What's your general assessment of Hillary Clinton's visit?
I think from the American point of view, it was a successful visit. I mean, she got most of the things she came in for. Magically, before she landed in Delhi, the Sharm el-Sheikh joint statement materialized. It was a surprise to many observers because just a month before that, at the Shanghai Cooperation Summit meeting, the Indian Prime Minister adopted such a hawkish stance. He told the media in front of the Pakistani president. I mean, he imposed conditionalities in
right.
Full view of the media. So I think, invisible American hand was there behind this hastily drafted joint statement.
Quite.
And of course, she did the Indian government finalized the deal for setting up the two American nuclear reactors. Then
right.
Also, they've almost finalized the deal for the purchase, for the selling of American weaponry to India.
With the end use agreement.
With the end use agreement, which of course has turned out to be very controversial in India.
Right.
So I think, from the American point of view, it has been quite successful, but there are a lot of misgivings.
And from the Indian point of view, in the run-up to this, going back to the Indo-US agreement and the strategic partnership which was signed between President Bush and PM Manmohan Singh, there was this talk of a strategic partnership between the two countries building up. How far has that gone from an Indian point of view? Because it seems to me that this visit has had one-way successes.
Yes, I think it's not going as per the Indian script. I think the Obama administration is in some ways quite different from the previous Bush administration. And the previous Bush administration had two very staunch strategic allies in Asia, one is being Israel, the other being India. So the Obama administration, the focus is on Afghanistan, on defeating the Taliban in Afghanistan,
right.
No longer diverted to Iraq. Of course, the Americans still have interest in Iraq. So, Indian concerns, I don't think, are taken on board as seriously as it was during the Bush administration.
Right.
So,
and what Indian concerns do you think could have been put across to the U.S. during this visit, which were not?
Pakistan. The Indian government feels that Pakistan has once again become a very close ally of the American administration. And interestingly, there's a lot of misgivings about the importance being given to China by the Obama administration. So the Indian establishment sort of feels that they are being neglected by the Obama administration.
Right.
And it took 6 months for Hillary to make a visit here. Of course, they say it's because of the elections and other
and her broken issue. Elbow.
And broken elbow.
Yeah.
And you remember there was this, attempt by the Obama administration to add Kashmir to the AFPAC mix.
Sure.
So all this, I think.
Sure. So from the American viewpoint, they have clearly seized upon this strategic partnership as a as another market open for their military hardware. And a new state to push their foreign policy perspectives through, and thence the end-user agreement. How do you see this end-use agreement, given the fact that the Americans have always maintained that similar agreements are entered into by all countries to whom the U.S. supplies military hardware?
Yeah, I mean, the Indian side should have realized when the this is signed on to first the defense agreement with America and then later on to the nuclear deal. I mean, well-meaning Indians had warned the Indian government that these are the pitfalls if you join with the Americans, become their closest ally in the region. So the end use agreement, I think, is just fallout of these two agreements. And I think it's a very intrusive agreement. I mean, India is not like Pakistan or any other country. I think it's it's a betrayal of our foreign policy principles and allowing Americans to, troops, for American forces, American inspectors to come to our bases, military bases.
The Indian government, however, claims that they will not allow US inspectors into our bases, that we have the option of choosing the time and place where such inspections are to take place. Do you think that holds water?
No, I don't think that holds water. In fact, the defense minister said the other day that there is no firm agreement on this issue, and India will never allow this to happen. Right. I don't know how far this is true, but the Americans are insisting. They say it's part of any deal they do with any other country.
Right. Therefore, apart from the end-use agreement, there were the other agreements on science, technology and other spheres. In substantive terms, there doesn't seem to have been much forward movement in terms of the strategic partnership as far as India was concerned. And as far as America is concerned, they've just opened the doors for a few more sales.
Yes, absolutely right. So, thank God that, the strategic partnership has not been deepened further. One gets a feeling that the honeymoon between the Americans and the Indian elite is on the verge of getting over. Now you see the reaction to the Sharm el Sheikh agreement.
Right.
So they feel that this is being pressed on them by the Americans, and you also see that the so-called American support for the Pakistani state and their Clinton's open support for the anti-terror activities of the Pakistani.
So
all this is not going down well with the elite here.
A last question. It's now, I think, fairly clear that Pakistan has finally decided to take on the anti-Pakistan Taliban inside Pakistan, but has not shown similar determination either vis-a-vis the anti-Afghanistan or anti-US Taliban, and certainly not vis-a-vis the extremist forces fighting against India. Pakistan has wanted that India lay off on this border so that they can concentrate on that. Do you see this going back to the old days where the US and Pakistan enter a relationship where they serve each other's interests and leave India once again in the cold?
Yes, there is a danger of that happening. You must have read today's stories, the ISI, senior ISI officials talking to the New York Times.
Right.
They said that they still consider India as their major enemy. And in fact, they have advised America to go slow on the offensive against the Taliban.
Right.
They want Americans to talk to the so-called good Taliban.
Right.
So, and then of course, to complicate matters, the allegations of Indian involvement
in Balochistan.
And it's not a well-kept secret. I mean, we are doing some things there. And the Pakistani establishment fears that once the Americans leave Afghanistan, which many people think is only a matter of time, they will once again be surrounded by enemies, on their western border.
So the honeymoon period may be over as far as the Obama administration is concerned. Mm. Maybe this may strike some sections of the Indian elite, but do you think this has sunk into the Indian government?
No, not yet. Our Prime Minister is inherently pro-American in his outlook. I mean, he wants India to become a great power, and the Americans are sort of playing on this, the hope that India one day will become a great power.